Good evening, welcome to Cardiff City TV.
He'll shoot and he'll score!
Good afternoon, welcome to Cardiff City TV. Welcome to the Cardiff City Stadium for this afternoon's game between the Bluebirds and top of the table Fulham, with the Bluebirds looking to bounce back from that disappointing injury time loss in midweek against in-form Huddersfield. I'm Ashley James, alongside me as ever for home games this afternoon, my colleague John Donovan. And John, I guess it's going to fly in the face of what we've spoken about for much of the season. We've been proponents of the fact that this is a very, very weak championship, but Fulham are raising their head above the parapet, or have done all season. They're a petrifying prospect, and this is a real challenge for Cardiff this afternoon.
It is a challenge. It could be a bit of a scary challenge, but I'm looking on the positive side, Ash. And I remember the season before promotion last time out, Neil Warnock had been in situ for a while, and I remember we went to Brighton away from home, and he said, I want my team to see the standard they have to set for next season. And I wonder whether there's a little bit about it today. We need to be competitive. We obviously, a win or a positive result would be fantastic, but more than anything, particularly if Steve Morrison remains in situ, we need to see the standard of a promotion winning team or a promotion challenging team. You are right though. I know you and I both look at transfer market before the game, and normally you look at goals and assists, and the third or fourth player on the list has maybe two goals and one assist. I think the third player on the list of Fulham is eight goals and six assists or something. They are frighteningly strong. They are frighteningly strong offensively. They can kill a game very quickly. No lead is ever safe against them. This is going to be a major test this afternoon.
I've seen Cardiff obviously announce the team ahead of game, and there are changes for the Bluebirds. Speculation online, you can see when we release the team that maybe Steve Morrison had one eye looking ahead at Tuesday. I can kind of quash those rumours and say no, there is a sickness bug in the camp at the moment. It's hit the team yesterday and this morning, which means that there have been changes enforced by that. That explains the absence of Uche Ikpeazu in the matchday squad. It explains the absence of Marlon Pack, and explains the drop into the bench of a number of players as well. Mark Harris not involved. Jordan Hugill drop into the bench as well. But it does afford opportunities to other players. So in, you know, comes Captain Joe Rawls back in the team. Reuben Colwell, a huge opportunity for him. He must be chomping at the bit to get back in a starting lineup. You know, he's been probably a frustrating second half of the season for him already. So there are opportunities there, not least for Colwell. And Alfie Doughty, of course, back in the starting 11, way ahead of what he'd have expected in terms of a schedule.
Well, I know in modern day football, Ash, we don't talk about this so much because there's rotation and horses for courses and changing the team to suit the opponents. If ever there was a earn your shirt team, I think it's the day. I think Steve Morrison has sent players out, albeit enforced, with perhaps a message ringing in their ears. Give me a selection headache. There is a little bit of competition for places now. Yes, we're not as strong as today's visitors, Fulham, but the last couple of weeks we've said about the bench that Cardiff all of a sudden look like they've got a little bit of strength in depth. Well, now it's a chance for players who maybe haven't had that starting berth to go out and earn the shirt. Great competition at left wing. Back Joel Bacon has been superb for four or five games. Alfie Doughty was playing so well before his injury. I think he's an intelligent player. I think different to Ryan Giles. I trust him a little bit more defensively in his own areas of the pitch. He doesn't have that bursting, searing pace of a Ryan Giles, but I think he's a clever footballer, so I look forward to welcoming him back into the fold today. But yeah, Reuben Colwell's got a kick on. I think he's been some subject to some tough love from Steve Morrison, as a number of the players have. We know all about Reuben Colwell's ability, his balance on the ball, his ability to go both ways. He's got a goal in him. But he's got to show his manager now he's ready to be a consistent starter. Big day for Ruben today, and big day for a number of these players to show the manager they deserve a place in this team.
And the inclusion of Reuben Colwell means tactically, maybe for the first time in a few games, it's going to be interesting to see what Cardiff go to. Ryan Wintle, another of those that's been forced to drop to the bench today because of that illness. Does that mean that Will Volks drops to play as the middleman of the three? Does it mean that Joe Rawls maybe has an experimental game as the middleman of the three coming in? Because I thought Volks played very well on the right of the three in midweek. Colwell, is he going to play right up top alongside James Collins, who's, you know, grasping for that shirt as well? Or is he going to play as a 10 in a almost a midfield diamond with the overlapping wingbacks?
I think, first of all, to answer the Volks question, when I've put out the team on my team sheet, I have him as the holding player, simply because I think Steve Morrison, when I've seen him utilise Joe Rawls, wants to utilise him as someone, as a more advanced midfielder who can burst and get between or get past the attacking line and be another option into the box. So I suggest that Will Volks will hold, but there is flexibility there. Reuben Colwell, I think he'll be a little bit of a free roll for him today. I think he'll be asked to drift. I think he'll be asked maybe... We're playing against a team... We played against Blackpool last week, Ash, and it's one of the few teams that play with a flat back four. Fulham as well. You know, so commonly now we see three centre-halves. They look like they're playing with a four. Can Colwell drift and pull people out of position and make room for people like Rawls to get into a secondary space or someone like Tommy Doyle to get into a little bit of space? So I think Reuben Colwell will be given a little bit of a free roll, asked to work, asked to press. And I think Steve Morrison, you know, we saw with Max Waters the other day, Ash, Reuben Colwell will have to press, will have to do work without the ball. But I think he's going to be given a little bit of a license to roam and try and cause Fulham a few problems.
We mentioned the man's name a lot there ahead of kickoff today, mainly because of the much changed, enforced changes to the team today because of that illness. Let's hear from him directly. Then this is what Steve Morrison had to say yesterday when he caught up with the press.
This game Saturday is our ninth, 9 out of 11 that we've had in this run. I've said for 80 minutes, they're excellent. Kicking the teeth at the death. And yeah, we dust ourselves down and we just go again. It's just football, isn't it? It's there's no real morale in the camps. Fine. Staff are all good. Yeah, look forward to a game at the stadium. No travelling on Saturday. Yeah, they've been fantastic, haven't they? And let's get it right, they should be where they are. They pay more money than anybody else. They have a bigger budget than anybody else. They've got the best striker in the league. They've got fantastic players all around them. So it's a great challenge. It's a great test. And we'll go to work like we do in all of the other games and put a plan together to try and nullify them as much as we can and then use our strengths to try and hurt them as well. He's got the luxury of being able to do everything. And that's what you want as a centre forward. Got to stop the ball into his feet. If they go a bit longer, he can get all of that as well. He can win balls in the air. He's an all-round striker. No surprise, he's top goal scorer. He's broke records in a record-breaking season for Fulham. And yeah, we just have to try and limit his service and limit the amount of opportunities he gets. As we all know, it only takes him one to score as well. So, hey, it's a big ask. But then obviously they got to stop our moments as well. So, and said it's only a game of football at the end of the day. Yeah, let's hope it's not the Mitrovic show. Well, Liverpool was the ultimate test. Take 3-1 off the back of Liverpool, like they're beating teams 5 and 6-0. So yeah, it's another test. Every game's a test, especially the top teams who are flying and have got confidence in abundance. They're massive games. They're tough tests, but ones that we've stood up to so far, and I expect the team to do that again this weekend. We've got a good as chance tomorrow as anyone has. It's a game of football, and we'll go there and we'll be the best version of ourselves we can be. And ultimately, hopefully we can tip that 20,000 mark. We're getting closer to it for games, and then yeah, we've got huge games every week. Derby on Tuesday at home, it's great, and this is what as a footballer. Upsetting the odds and being against the odds is a great place to be. Hopefully, we can put on a show at home of real strength and unity on the pitch, and then obviously hopefully we can get a result at the end of it. But we're definitely not sitting here thinking to ourselves we ain't going to get nothing from this game. Let's look forward to Derby. It's every game's a winnable game, as we know with the Championship.
Welcome back to Cardiff City Stadium, here with myself and John Donovan, ahead of kickoff with the Bluebirds facing top of the table Fulham this afternoon. And not to bury the lead, we spoke about it in that first segment as well. They are a frankly terrifying prospect in a league that otherwise has lacked top-tier quality this season. I mean, the stats speak for themselves. 9 times this season they've scored more than 4 goals. They've put seven past two teams. They've put six past another two teams. You just hope this afternoon, from Cardiff's point of view, you keep organised, you don't concede that early goal.
I completely agree. But I got to give credit, because I was, you know, you imagine Marco Silva and Fulham, and you look at the money they spend, and you think it's just all offence. And for the large part, it is. But they still play with two solid centre-halves, and they still play with two holding midfielders, which then allows the full-backs to burst forward and allows the kind of the front four, led by Mitrovic, but, you know, three in behind, to do their work in the final third. So it is, you know, money does talk at this level, and they spent money well for this level, but I still do like their structure, and I think they are the outstanding team in this division. You know, Bournemouth have a couple of games in hand, but they'd still be behind Fulham if they won it. You don't see Fulham blowing it from here. Their bench is scary. Their ability to rotate the squad, of course, ex-Bluebird Harry Wilson coming back in today. He was on the bench in their last game against Peterborough. To have that strength in depth, you know, we talked about the Bluebirds getting a little bit more strength in depth. It's a different world at Fulham, and they should, you know, with the money they spent, be a Premier League club. There has been that little bit of rivalry between Cardiff and Fulham going back to that promotion chasing year, where you did feel the media wanted Fulham to go up, and Cardiff spoiled the party. But I don't think anyone's spoiling Fulham's party this year.
Yeah, I mean, and they've made changes, haven't they? You know, look at the team today, a bit of rotation from them. Joe Bryan, sort of frustrating season, comes back in at left back. You said there's a rotation behind Mitrovic today. Bobby Decker, Dover Reed and Harry Wilson play, and it's tended to be one or the other in recent weeks. Both are in really good form. Carvalho's been magnificent this season as the 10. And there's a change in the middle of the park with Jean-Michel Seri, thankfully. A £24 million Jean-Michel Seri drops out. But Nathaniel Chalabar is an experienced operator at this level and comes in. Two defeats in 20, and they haven't hit the heights that we've spoken about there in terms of goal scoring in recent weeks. But much like they did under Scott Parker 2 years ago, much like they did when they were chasing us down from promotion, the second half of the season, they tend to find an ability to just grind out results and keep things motoring along.
Consistency, you know, they don't lose games, they pick up points, they score late winners or what have you. You're absolutely right, they find that level which you need to dog it out. Of course, they've still got their quality as well. But actually, you mentioned Reuben Colwell. I think our wing-backs are key today. For once, it's two different formations going against each other, as it was against Blackpool last weekend. If we can get Colwell and one of the wing-backs overloading against maybe an out-and-out full-back, or keep their full-backs penned in a little bit more, I think maybe we can have a little bit of success. If Fulham just control the territory and their full-backs can step in and play with their front four, we're in for a very, very long afternoon. We know Cody Drama can do it. We know Alfie Doherty was starting to do it before his injury. So for me today, it's important that the wing-backs, almost the first line of defence, is the wing-backs trying to get advanced up the pitch, force Fulham backwards and pen Fulham's full-backs, traditional full-backs, in a little bit more. And I think Reuben Colwell, as a supporting player to that, creating overloads, is key. But that's easier said than done. And this Fulham team, as you say, we don't face Seri today, but they've still got two good holding midfielders who break up play and then just give the simple pass to the players in front of them. And if they have possession of the ball for 60-70%, which they may well do, you're worried about the potential damage they can cause Cardiff City.
Let's talk about the man himself then, Alexander Mitrovic. Steve Morrison was asked the question before the game, you know, and I'm sure he's been asked before the game. He was certainly asked yesterday when he spoke to the press, how do you stop him? And it was a blunt answer: you don't. You try and stop the supply to him. The stats are just eye-watering. You know, 33 goals in 32 appearances this season, 33 and 30 in the Championship. He's only the third player to reach 30 goals in the Championship era. And now, Peter Whittingham, God bless him, no, Guy Whittingham, his namesake, you know, that record of 42 goals in the second tier is just looked unthinkable when you looked at it. And it's now in play. He's got 9 goals and he's got 14 games to get it. It's just absolutely remarkable.
It is, and I'm still surprised every transfer window that nobody in the Premiership has a look at him. I know he's never delivered fully in the Premiership, but you know, he's obviously comfortable in West London. The mere mention of Guy Whittingham there makes me feel old. I remember him starting out at Portsmouth and Aston Villa and what have you. Mitrovic could readily do it, but I agree with Steve Morrison. I've seen teams try to stop Mitrovic directly, you know, man-to-man with a big, burly centre-half. He can bully them. We've seen teams try and put a shield in front and almost sandwich in with that 2-on-1. he's found ways around that because his movement in the box from post to post is so clever. So I think you've almost got to stop the threat at source, and that's stopping the supply coming into the box. But where do you stop the supply? Do you stop the crosses from wide areas, Ash? Do you stop the clever little interchange on the edge of the box with people like Wilson and Deca Dovary? Because Mitrovic is not just a target man. His movement is good. So Folks is going to be key. To maybe shield a little bit, stopping crosses from wide. So again, I come back from the wing backs. It's all easier said than done, but I do agree with Steve Morrison. I'm not sure you can stop Aleksandar Mitrovic, but maybe try and stop the supply to him.
Final question then, before the game, I think we've kind of touched on it a little bit already, but he'll be frustrated to have to obviously rip up his plans, Steve Morrison, and make these changes in light of the illness ahead of the game. But deep down secretly, will we be thinking this as a bit of a roll of the dice and an opportunity here to see some of these players and how much they want to keep holding this jersey for another big game coming on Tuesday?
Exactly that. Cardiff have a puncher's chance. You know, the game starts at 0-0. That was a very good shot by Andy Dibble then, almost taking Ashley James out.
He's one of the good guys as well.
He did have a smile on his face and apologised. I think Cardiff have a puncher's chance because Fulham are favourites here all day long. The game starts at 0-0. Every game is a contest. Cardiff, they have to try and win the midfield battle. They have to try and utilise their wing-backs. For me, maybe the bigger picture is looking at this. We've mentioned Reuben Colwell a lot. Can you play a 90-minute consistent game, be a threat, cause problems for the opposition, and therefore put some thought in your manager's mind that we can go back to not necessarily playing with a front two, but playing with a 10? And that goes for a number of players as well. So, message today, I think, from Steve Morrison, from all of us, earn the shirt.
Thank you, John. As ever, enjoy commentary this afternoon. John and Mark Denham on audio commentary this afternoon. If you're tuning into the game, thank you for doing so. To watch the game on Cardiff City TV, you've got myself and Connor Pearce for company. John's just mentioned how important the midfield battle is going to be this afternoon, and a man key to that is going to be Tommy Doyle. Scored his first Cardiff goal in midweek at Huddersfield, and this is what he had to say when we caught up with him yesterday.
Yeah, so thanks for joining us first and foremost, Tommy. How has training been since Wednesday?
Yeah, good. You know, I think obviously after the game, you know, it's all focused onto the next game and moving on as quick as possible. And like I say, we've got obviously a game again tomorrow, so coming thick and fast. So it's just about getting ready as quick as you can and getting ready to perform.
A busy period of fixtures recently, so I imagine, you know, really looking forward to getting into this next one against another big opponent.
Obviously, it's one you want as a footballer. You want to be playing as many games as possible. And, you know, like I say, I think it's just about, you know, when you play a game, you move on and then you're on to the next and ready for it.
Personally, on level for you as well, first goal on Wednesday despite the result in the end?
Yeah, no, obviously it feels good, but bad thing is we didn't win the game, so it feels good for me on that note. But you know, I want to win games, and you know, unfortunately we couldn't hold on, but for me obviously it's good to score, but you know, it's just a shame we couldn't win the game.
I imagine it's one of them where you're starting to continue to try and look up that table a bit more with a good couple of fixtures coming up as well.
Yeah, I mean, every game, you know, we go into, we want to win. Obviously, some games are, you know, more challenging than others, and, you know, different games offer different things. And for us, I just think it's about preparing as well as possible, you know, keeping ourselves fit. And you know, when we get into the games, giving everything we've got, you know, there's obviously we've got a good squad and, you know, everyone's ready to play, which is a good thing. And when we're in, we just make sure we give 110% and hopefully we can win some more games.
I know that you're looking forward to playing in every game that you can, but against Fulham, you know, a team who are flying high at the top of the league at the moment, I imagine that's a challenge that you're really looking forward to.
I mean, every game offers its own challenges. And, you know, a team like Fulham, who are obviously doing well and setting the benchmark in the league, you know, it's good to be able to play against them and you know, challenge them. You know, obviously it's a game that we want to win and a game that we're going into, you know, wanting to win. And obviously we're going to challenge them as much as we can. And, you know, hopefully at the end of the 90 minutes, we come away with 3 points.
How good were the supporters on Wednesday and how much are you looking forward to seeing them again at CCS tomorrow?
Yeah, they're unbelievable. Honestly, they are. They're unbelievable. You know, they help us a lot. You know, they don't stop singing from start to finish. And, you know, it makes a big difference for us as players on the pitch when you hear them singing, you know, you just keep going, and it gives you, you know, extra fight and extra motivation to keep going. And you know, obviously home and away, they're brilliant. So again, they'll be the 12th man for us on the game tomorrow. And you know, like I say, we're going there to win.
Top 5 in association with the Big Yellow Self Storage Company.
Tackle by Keltier, defines the influential Lexim as Gunnison. Through Pilkington, good footwork from him, and a second time, edge of the area, Anthony Pilkington. Oh, it's a... What a strike! Cardiff have taken the lead! And it's two wonder goals for the Bluebirds.
It's exceptional, it's down this end again. Cardiff City in front of their own fans. Anthony Pilkington wrong foots two defenders.
I'm the chairperson of a DSA committee. Within the DSA, we've got over 100 members. Our main focus is to get a better match day experience for fans. We have a DSA room in the corner of the Canton stand that allows all the disabled fans to go for some warmth and get discounted tea and coffee. We have a notice board there with any events we have with the club. And we've also got on the board foundation events.
My name's Christopher. I'm a disability coordinator and equality, diversity and inclusion lead at Cardiff City Football Club Foundation. We're coming into Level Playing Fields, a campaign that's starting on the 26th of February. The focus for that campaign will be around hidden disabilities, so disabilities that are not immediately obvious, and that is the case for most disabilities. In partnership with the Football Club and the Disability Supporters Association, we at the Foundation are trying to promote the facilities that we have that include the sensory room, audio descriptive commentary, and all the accessibility issues that the stadium offers.
We have a reopening of the sensory room for the Fulham fixture. It will give a lot of our fans who are afraid to attend a match because they have sensory issues such as ADHD, they may have MND, so they can use the sensory room, and then rather than sitting with the rest of the fans where it's noisy, they have a quiet room where they could view the game.
The sensory room has a number of differing facilities that aim to make people with hidden disabilities like autism spectrum disorder comfortable and give them a safe and welcoming environment to enjoy a football match in, which gives them again slightly withdrawn area to watch the game from. That's helpful and helps them to adapt to the environment of a busy football stadium.
Good evening, welcome to Cardiff City TV.
He'll shoot and he'll score! What in the area! And it's Mark who did it!
Good afternoon, welcome to Cardiff City TV, welcome to Cardiff City Stadium.
Good to hear you there.
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2, mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Good afternoon, welcome to Cardiff City TV, welcome to...
Are you trying to get all that mic there?
Cardiff City Stadium for this live commentary with the Bluebirds hosting top of the table Fulham here at a sunny yet wintry Cardiff City Stadium. Changes, and enforced changes, are the headline news ahead of kickoff here as we welcome the two teams to the field down beneath us, led out by captains Joe Rolls and Tim Ream. Yeah, changes and enforced changes, the narrative of the afternoon. An illness not related to COVID, thankfully, is playing its part at the moment in the Cardiff squad, and that means that Steve Morrison's largely had to rip up his pre-match plans and make some enforced changes ahead of kickoff this very morning. Back comes Joe Rolls, back in comes Alfie Doughty, way ahead of schedule than we expected with that ankle injury. There's a starting spot also for young Reuben Colwell and also for James Collins up top. No Uche Ekpeazu whatsoever, no Mark Harris. They are the two main casualties, and also several players have had to drop to the bench. Changes as well for Fulham, but that's rotation. Bobby Decker, Dover Reid and Harry Wilson both start behind striker Alexandra Mitrovic after they've been rather rotated in recent weeks. Mitrovic, of course, a record setter already, 33 goals in 30 championship games this season. It's a modern day record. He's just the third player in the championship era to reach 30 goals. He's now staring down the barrel of Guy Whittingham's record of 42 set way back when in 1992-93.
Are the Bobby Army ready to go? That's the question. You're off to get on your feet. Open your mouth, support the boys, and will be Mitrovic to kick off.